start over here. This right here is a speaker, or the symbol for a speaker on schematic. It's got a cone and a little rectangle behind it to simulate the electromagnet, and then the two wires for the electromagnet. This right here means two wires are connected. This right here means two wires are connected. This means two wires are unconnected. It's bridged over. If it's like this with a little space in between right there and there, it means they're unconnected. This right here is unknown. This is a very bad, if anybody uses this in the schematic, it'll take their time or they just don't use a thought process on the fact, because sometimes people put them like this and mean that they're connected. Sometimes they put them like that and mean they're not connected, because they don't have to know the difference between this dot is on a diagram. This is a battery, a DC battery. You don't have AC batteries. This is a AC power supply, a little sine wave in the center of it. This is actually a solar cell. See that as the arrows going in, meaning the light coming in powers this, and that's why it's got a little battery symbol in the center of it. This is earth ground. This is signal ground. I'm sorry, this is ground for multiple locations. This is signal ground. This is earth ground. This right here is a photoresistor or a photocell, and what it does is as light comes in, the resistance gets higher or lower depending on the photoresistor or photocell. And you can use this in a lot of circuits to detect light. You know, if the light's off, the resistance is higher or lower, or whatever the case may be. This is a variable resistor or potentiometer. You can use a rheostat or a potentiometer, rheostats, or for high power, high current applications where a potentiometer is for low current, low power applications. This is a symbol for a resistor, very badly drawn, I'm sorry. This is a symbol for an antenna, ham radio, if you're into that or anything like that. This is a symbol for a capacitor, could be ceramic or mylar, non-polarized. This is a symbol for a polarized capacitor. I know that little plus symbol is hard to see because the light is reflecting on there, but that's, there we go. That's a polarized capacitor. This is a variable capacitor with a little arrow pointing through. This right here is an air core inductor transformer. You apply a voltage on one side, you get a voltage on the other side due to magnetic flux. This is basically just an inductor symbol, still light reflecting. That's an inductor. This is a solid core transformer. There's an inductor on both sides, using an iron core, most common. This right here is a crystal. You got two powers on the side, and a crystal in the center. This right here is your schematic for an NPN transistor. Emitter, base, and collector. Same here as a PNP. You got your emitter, base, collector. Base is always the one that goes to the little line. Collector is the one that don't have an arrow on it, and emitter is the one that has an arrow going either toward the base or away from the base, depending on if it's PNP or in or independent. And there's an operational amplifier used in a lot of circuits. So this right here is a, this is an LED symbol. Anything that looks like a diode that has arrows going off of it is an LED. And make sure the arrows are pointing away, because you do have diodes that point toward your photodiodes. They vary by the light. This is a Zenser diode. Has basically looked kind of like a Z, I guess. We say that's Zenser because it's a Z. But this is Zenser. And this is your standard diode, rectifying diode, or whatever you want to call it. This is a push button switch. It's up, which means it's always not connected. And then one down, there are switches that are always connected until pushed. And that's the basics for reading basic schematic. symbols for IC, which look like this, and they have a pinout. I'm sorry, they don't actually have a pinout. Most of the time, they're just a block. And the leads come out from all different sides with different numbers, but like that. You have, you know, this may be one, and then it rotates around to three, or it actually may not stay in order, because the actual IC may be, 8 pins or whatever. For instance, the operational amplifier, the LM386, does not look like a triangle. It looks like maybe this. It's got 4 pins on each side. You've got a voltage pin to power. It looks like that, but the pinout, you go look at the pinout and see what the pins do on the data sheet. And then you would correspond the pins to this, as this is the non-inverting and the inverting, and then the output, and then the power to the negative power and the positive power supply. And you figured out where they go on the actual IC. Alright, I think that covers everything here. And any questions, just comment. Thank you.